when I finally get over this mountain and see clear on the other side.
Hey folks, welcome. We are here today at Trinity Music City Studios in Hendersonville, Tennessee, and coming at you live. And we got my good guest right here today, Mr. Marty Raybon. Welcome, Marty.
How you doing, Mike?
I'm doing great, man. A lot of stuff going on with you.
Hey, welcome to the studio. We're doing our little thing today. We've been tracking, fixing to do a little bit of the vocals here in a little bit, and then after that, then we'll start the process of background vocals as well too. So, you know, kind of give everybody a, you know, kind of a little scenario of what's kind of behind the scenes.
Exactly. A lot of people don't know that, and that's what's exciting. And appreciate you inviting us in and letting us be a part of this today.
Well, I know when starting off in the music business with a lot of the same guys that you and I know, you know, man, I'd give anything in the world if I could have been just a fly on the wall, you know, when they were cutting it.
Exactly.
Or recording, you know, and even hearing stories afterwards about what they did in the studio, you know, to make that happen. You know, how did you get that sound? Or,
you know,
where were y'all standing around the microphone to make that happen and stuff like that, you know? And most of the time, the stuff, you know, what you had in your mind was so much bigger than what they told you. Well, we just stood in front of a mic and just sang.
Exactly.
You know, it was always... You know, whatever your preconceived notion usually wasn't it at all, but you made it a whole lot bigger than what it was.
Yeah, and the people, you know, and it's amazing to go back and see our history and stuff. And that's what you're doing right now. You're making memories and making some great music. So tell me about your new project. It's a new gospel project that you've started here. I know that you have made other projects and gospel, recorded a lot of gospel music in the past, but what makes this one a little bit different, would you say, than
Well, I think just really the maturity of my Christian walk, you know. You know, sometimes in our walk and in our quest to serve Christ, you know, whether we want to admit it or not, I mean, that we know in secret, you know, you might
That's
say,
right.
But every once in a while, you know, there is some failure, you know, in your life. Now, you know, you don't want to, you know, you literally want to live as Christ lived. You know, he's our example. That's the way you want to live. But,
exactly.
But you know, unfortunately, you know, I hadn't lived up to that mark. So therefore, not living up to that mark, for me, it's caused a great deal of maturity. And, you know, the things that I know I don't want to do again. Or the things that I want to do different that didn't work for me real, real good the first time.
Right.
You know, now, did that ever mean that I lost my salvation? Absolutely not. God loves me as much today and even through some of the bad times I was going through as he ever has. But I think this project is, when everybody hears it, I really believe wherever you are in your walk with Christ, I think it's going to be, you know, somebody could say, well, you know, that song don't fit me, but you know, that one right there does.
Right.
You know, so therefore, but in the walk that we have with Christ, everybody's at different levels.
That's so true.
You know, you can have as much or as little of Christ as you want. But the thing about it is, you know, as we're trying to get there, somebody could say, man, I'd give anything in the world, man, if I had the kind of faith old Billy Graham had. Well, do you have faith? Well, yeah. Well, you got as much as he's got.
Oh,
no, but man, he's done things. Well, look, all that's required of us is to have the faith the size of a mustard seed, and we can be saved.
That's exactly right.
You know, and with that faith, and therefore, you know, with the music on this project, I hope what it does is each story delegates itself to the heart of those that listen to it.
Right.
In other words, it ministers to people in different ways, and says things to people, you know, that need to be said in the way that maybe God may be imparting in their heart, or, you know, just, you know, what the lyric out and out just says to somebody. Because that's the great thing about what, you know, what music does. It does
that
for you.
It speaks. So in terms of a goal in a sentence, what would you say a goal for this project would be? An overall goal, and I know you mentioned some things, you know, as far as reaching the people and ministering.
Well, you know, to be honest with you, you know that it is survived as when people listen to it as message music.
Right.
You know, that it actually truly did say something. And I'll even go a little further. You know, a lot of record labels don't really care to hear this. And the reason why it is because, you know, the reason why the record labels are in business are to sell product. And, you know, which that's great. I mean, because that's what they're there for.
Business plan.
But one good, wonderful thing about Rural Rhythm with Sam Passamano and his family, the reason why I can say this and know that it's something that they feel as well too, probably one of the biggest things that I would want out of this album more than anything would be 1 million souls. Not
awesome.
As much 1 million souls.
There you go.
As much as 1 million souls.
Right.
You know, because
awesome.
To be honest with you, if a fraction of those people were reached, you know, then. You know, hey, it'd still be a good day for the kingdom.
That's it. Exactly.
Hi, folks. I'm Marty Raybon, and you're watching Behind the Dream.
This morning for breakfast so soon.
We'll be riding wildfire. We'll be riding wild.
No place that I'd rather be next to you, next to me. There ain't no place that I'd rather be
next to you, sitting next to me.
The children of Israel walked the desert. Oh, for 40 years they wandered all around. They cried out to God in all their hunger, and they knew when the manna came down. 'Cause when he rains, it pours. He can't open.
How did you come about getting all the songs together? I mean, did you write any? Is it original material? Is it?
Yeah, there's several tunes on there original. One in particular, you know, that I'd mentioned a while ago. You know, some of the things we do in life, we fail at. And at one time, I was walking with God at a guilty distance. And anyway, I told a buddy of mine, Gerald Crabb, I'd heard a fellow by the name of Johnny Hunt, which is an absolutely wonderful son. He's a go-getter. I mean, that old boy can carry the mail and he goes preaching. And anyway, I heard him make that statement in one of his sermons. You know, you're a little cold, you're a little calloused, you're a little distant. You're walking with God at a guilty distance. I thought, man, would that ever make a great, great song title? But to be quite honest with you, it was the message that really pierced my heart that he was talking about,
that's
because
awesome.
That's exactly what I was doing. You know, look, I had the suit and the loafers, and, you know, I made our way to our family pew, and, you know, I nodded my head at folks and wave and howdy and all that other kind of stuff. But, you know, man, I was out of the, in other words, I wasn't under the spout where the glory comes out. I was living rebelliously.
God, in all of his infinite mercy, came running to me when I called his name. Tired of walking with God at a guilty distance, the Spirit was strong against my resistance.
I didn't have what God was wanting to give me, you know. And anyway, so I realized that, you know, that if if I could be guilty of that, I realized that other people could too. So when I told my buddy Gerald Crabb about it, Gerald said, "Man," said Marty, "said you just told my story, bub."
Wow.
And I said, "Well, man, let's write it." I said, "The thing will write itself."
There you go.
Anyway, so we did, and then then we turned right back around and understand where God literally from the Bible said, "Look, you've never done anything so bad that I can't come get you." You who are burdened and heavy laden, come to me and I'll give you rest.
There you go.
So that from the guttermost to the uttermost, it don't make any difference,
The testimony
that kind
part.
Of stuff.
We don't have a testimony till we have a test.
That's right. In fact, I worked 31 years I worked on mine.
Well, we all work on ours. It's a daily deal. That's
sure,
awesome.
Yeah, to anybody else.
So about the song, the title of the project, the name of the project
be
looking for.
It. To be honest with you, because of the message music and because of some of the content of the lyric, it's to be the worker in the field. I truly believe wholeheartedly that we're living in the days that we need to comprehend that the coming of the Lord is short coming.
Amen.
And therefore we need to keep our hand to the plow. And that's what the Word of God says, and it does say that. It says, that once you put your hand to the plow, that man, you don't look back.
That's it.
You keep on getting up. As my daddy said, son, you can give out, just don't give up.
That's it. You and I both can probably say we're farmers from that era too.
Yeah.
And have worked out there, so we know what plowing's about.
Yeah. Well, I had to plow through an old block brick field. My daddy was a brick mason, had to plow through, which I hoed a lot.
Well, there you go.
When I was cutting that mortar.
Oh boy, and you knew it from daylight to dark.
Yeah.
So we know hard work.
But the thing about the record is hopefully the freshness that it brings because of the the way that we recorded it. We recorded it modern, it's not so modern that it's far-fetched or it's out of the reach so that people can just plainly understand it, because I truly believe wholeheartedly that one of the biggest things in the world that you could ever make a mistake on is if you're trying to explain what you think somebody needs to know, and you explained it over their head.
Simple works.
Yeah, simplicity always works.
Simplicity always works.
So therefore, I think that's probably the reason for the lure of the tunes that I didn't write. Some of the things that I found, I think that was the lure of while listening to them, what they said. Barry Hutchins wrote a tune called "A Bright New Morning," and I think it's just really, it just really tells such a wonderful story. That one of these old days, I'm gonna get over this mountain, or either I'm gonna get out of this valley, and
will be gone. They will be gone on a bright new morning. The sun on my face, where my heart is warm and safe.
Sun on my face, where my heart is warm and safe, and just that kind of stuff. It's not real preachy stuff. It's just stuff that just really honest to it. Just says stuff to people, or
it
certainly did to me, and I felt like if it ministered to me, it ministered to somebody else.
I'm most certain. So your fans, something you'd really like for your fans to take from it, if they go out and buy Marty Raybon's new CD, what would you like for your fans to really pull from that? What would you to really take home with them, or when they hear this?
Well, honestly, my prayer would be that it literally, for those that need their life to be impacted to the nuff of salvation, then that's what I would want that enough to be. You know, I'd want it to that's be awesome. Enough that mm-hmm. somebody would change their mind and their heart and their spirit. You know, that it would say something to somebody that would say, you know, I'd give anything in the world if I had what that song makes me feel like. Keep it right here. We'll be right back.
Marty Raybon, brand new album, Hand to the Plow. 10 new powerful songs. Soar through a musical journey with I've Seen What He Can Do. Going under. Forgiveness washed and clean. Mercy made. Be a part of Marty's inspirational trip with A Bright New Morning. The sun on my face. And when he rains, it pours. Call the number on your screen now and get this CD for only $13.98. Send check or money order to Rural Rhythm, P.O. Box 750, Mount Juliet, Tennessee 37121. Like us on Facebook and go to our website, www.ruralrhythm.com.
I'll sing you a song, though not very long, yet I think it's as pretty as any. Put your hand in your purse, you'll never be worse, and give that poor sinner a penny.
Funny.
Well, it makes good for a bedtime story, but it's time to go to bed.
Papa, what does God look like?
I was tucking her in bed, and it caught me by surprise when my little girl asked me, what does God look like? Well, I smiled and laughed a little, leaned over for a kiss. I said, baby, I don't know, but I can tell you this. I've been to the ocean, and I stood on a mountain. I've seen a sunset burn away a sky of blue. Stared up at the starlight, got lost in the midnight. I've never seen the face of God, but I've seen what He can do. Well, I've thought about the wonders around us every day, the stuff that if you let it, it would take your breath away. I've also found His glory shining from within the heart of a sinner who's just been born again. I've been to the river, watched souls going under, forgiveness washed and clean, mercy made them new. God is the old man, and I can tell you firsthand, I've never seen the face of God, but I've seen what He can do. Somehow this whole world helps me see Him clearer. Cause I've walked in the valley, cried out from the sorrow. I can tell you every fight that He has brought me through. And I know Him better, love Him forever. Can do.
You know, and all these influences make us individually who we are, musically. And just like the mentors you were speaking about, our spiritual mentors, people that we draw from, we can learn from.
Yeah.
And that's what's so good. You know, we were fortunate enough to know first-generation players.
Yeah.
Bill Monroe's, Ralph Stanley's, Jim and Jesse, all these guys paved the route.
Yeah.
Merle Haggard.
You Don Reno's and Red Smiley, but, you know, Bill Harold's. And
oh, we could go on and on.
You know,
Troopers, just, you know.
You know, some of the best advice that I'd ever gotten, I told Ronnie about this one day. My brothers and I, we were in Augusta, Georgia at Fort Gordon. We were doing a show. So was Reno and Harold. Buck Ryan was still living. Ed Ferris was playing bass. And they were just four-piece. And anyway, so there was my two brothers and I, Chuck Denmark and Steve Pruitt. Steve Pruitt played banjo. Chuck Denmark played mandolin. And we were a little five-piece band. Anyway, a fellow by the name of Ed Hurt hired us, and we played up to a certain point. And what it was is really nothing more than just a man, you know, guys, you're doing a great job, you know, in your Army life. And this, and it was just one of them kind of days of a really Thanksgiving to the soldiers and stuff. Now, now you got to think, now this is back in, you know, 75, you know, 76, around in there. Anyway, so nonetheless, that night, we were going to play over at another part of the base. And Reno and Harold was going to play the officers' mess, or the commander's
party
club, or whatever that was. Anyway, that's what they were doing. And anyway, so we stayed at a colonel's house, and there was nobody there but us. But he loaned us his house so that we could go and relax. And and of course, you know, Don, that, he wasn't feeling real good that day, but. You know, we talked, and the one thing, you know, Don said, look, he said, you know, the one thing about it is, he said, you know, first, he said, man, just always try to love God. And he said, then, you know, then try to love your family. And he said, you know, then try to make sure you don't ever get so mad or aggravated with somebody that you may not ever have the opportunity to ever say you were sorry.
That's right.
Now, I'm going to be honest with you. At that time, let's see, I think I was maybe 16 years old. At that time, I heard what he said. But, you know, I mean, what I heard that I thought was really something is when he goes, man, you and your brothers, man, I love that sibling harmony. And said, man, you boys sing great together. But, you know, after thinking of everything in the world that he had said, what I really gleaned from it, what means more to me than anything else in the world, was the advice that he gave instead of the statement of what I took.
Right.
You know, instead of the compliment, you know, that I took and stuff like that.
Carried something home with
it. I find out that, you know and I've thought about this from time to time. Like I said, I'd mentioned it to Ronnie. What I'd gleaned from it more than anything else in the world was actually the heartfelt, what he was trying to, you know. In other words, it was almost to the point of like he was saying, look, get this. If you don't get anything else that I've said, you know, all this afternoon we've been together, we've told war stories of how it was years ago and this kind of stuff. If you boys heard anything,
right, get this,
man, get this. And you know, and that's I always thought that was such a great thing to say to somebody, you know, that literally was sitting there to be influenced.
Definitely making memories. And I'll tell you what, that's exactly what we are doing today. And I'm telling you, Marty, appreciate you being on the show.
Well, I'm going to have to come out to the house. Now, I know you and Brenda's invited me in time after time after time. And, of course, I'm going to have to get out there and eat some of them dumplings.
Come on out and eat some of them.
I'd love to have some of them stew beans and dumplings.
There you go. Well, we're excited about your new project for sure. And, folks, you really need to go to Real Rhythm Christian and check it out. And you'll see. Marty's new project's going to be on there, and like I said, we're real excited about it. And Marty, we wish you all the best and pray blessings on you, brother. And you're a good man, and we love you. We
bless you. I love you too, Mikey.
We keep us posted for sure. And thanks for letting us come in here today. You folks are watching Behind the Dream right here with Mike Scott. Y'all take care.
I'm working on a building.